Best places to travel this month of May. Number 1. Nantucket, Massachusetts. So much more than just a summer town, Nantucket is a beauty in every season. But there's extra incentive to visit in May, and not just to beat the summer influx of tourists. JetBlue, United, and American Airlines are launching direct service to the island throughout the month from East Coast cities including Boston, New York, Newark, Washington DC and Charlotte. Although there's still something to be said about the relaxed ferry ride from Martha's Vineyard. Plus, Nantucket becomes extra beautiful in late April, early May when more than 3 million daffodils blossom on the island. While you're not out biking, sailing, or strolling to nearby lighthouses, you better be eating seafood. Try the oysters at Crew open for the season in May, or Atlantic halibut at Upscale Dune for some unforgettable meals. To wind down at the end of a busy day, you can't do much better than the Wawinet. The 5-star hotel and 2020 Gold List winner is tucked away on the far northeastern side of the island, meaning the only crowds you'll run into are fellow guests and friendly staff members. Number 2. Tucson, Arizona. Arizona is less than ideal during the sweltering summer months, but it's one of the country's best places to travel in May. Tucson is a buzzing town well worth spending a long weekend in, thanks in large part to its incredible food scene. It was designated a city of gastronomy by UNESCO in 2015, and made headlines when the hot dogs at El Guero Canelo won a James Beard Award in 2018. Downtown is just a 20-minute drive from Saguaro National Park, where you can spot the country's largest cacti, some reach 50 feet, and wildflowers during the spring months. You don't want to miss any of those blooms or sunsets, so try to set up camp as close to the park as you can. Article's director Stephanie Wu swears by Posada by the Joshua Tree House, a Southwestern-inspired 5-room home available on Airbnb. It's so beautiful, you could get away with planning the entire trip around your stay there. Number 3. Machu Picchu. May marks the beginning of dry season in Peru, which makes it the perfect time to see the endpoint of the Inca Trail in its greenest glory. As an added bonus, visiting Machu Picchu in May helps you avoid the heaviest crowds of June, July, and August. This is one of those trips that you typically have to plan a year in advance, which means your 2022 has the potential to be pretty epic. Make sure to carve out some time to explore the city of Cusco, which most people use as a starting point for their Machu Picchu visit. They're about 2 hours apart by train. The Andean city oozes colonial charm, from its cobblestone roads to the Baroque architecture of its churches. Number 4. Holland, Michigan. If you're sad about missing tulip season in the Netherlands this year, consider planning a visit to Holland, Michigan. The appropriately named town and great day trip from Chicago is filled with old-fashioned windmills, re-envisioned Germanic villages, dainty gardens, and, best of all, millions of tulips. Try to time your visit to the town's annual Tulip Town Festival, held this year from May 1 to 9. The festival celebrates Holland's rich Dutch history with a Dutch market and costume exhibit, carnival, and flower-themed events like flower arranging lessons and yoga in the tulips. Book a room at Castle in the Country, a Victorian inn with a wrap-around porch and secluded location that lends itself perfectly to stargazing. Number 5. Mykonos, Greece. Greece recently announced international tourists will be welcome beginning May 14th, and we have our eyes set right on Mykonos. From Athens you can take a quick 40-minute flight to Mykonos or hop on a 2.5-hour high-speed ferry. The island has warm weather and thinner crowds than during the summer months, plus a few new hotels that we're particularly excited about. Just southeast of Mykonos town, Kensho Saro had its first full season in 2019, with 31 individually designed rooms and a stunning 4-bedroom villa. The hotel sat on the back burner in 2020, but is back with a few new additions in the works throughout this year. Also on our radars is the new Kaelsma Mykonos, opening May 20th. Be one of the first to experience the 5-star hotel's whitewashed, Cycladic look and panoramic views of the Aegean Sea. Number 6. Maryland Coast. The charming towns and countryside of the Chesapeake Bay are just as glorious as New England in the springtime, and not just because you get to fill up on Maryland blue crab sprinkled with Old Bay. Stop by the small town of St. Michael's, where maritime life looms large at its namesake museum and gorgeous harbor. When it comes to accommodations, go with the 78-room inn at Perry Cabin, a postcard-pretty hotel dating to the colonial era. If you'd rather go a little more city-centric, spend a long weekend in Annapolis. The capital city is particularly travel-worthy in May, with a farmer's market open every Sunday, notable concerts, and even a Mother's Day cruise around the city on May 9th. Number 7. Louisville, Kentucky. You haven't experienced true day drinking until you're sipping on a mint julep at Churchill Downs, home of the Kentucky Derby. Held on Saturday, May 1st this year, the iconic horse race is a great excuse to spend a long weekend in Louisville and break out your biggest hat. Just note that, due to the pandemic, reserved seats have been limited to 40-50% capacity as of writing, and general admission tickets have yet to be released. Once there, you should, of course, prioritize spending time at Churchill Downs, where you can visit the Kentucky Derby Museum, sip cocktails, and enjoy some fine dining at one of the venue's many restaurants and lounges. Book a room at 21C Museum Hotel, a regular favorite in our Reader's Choice Awards, for the exposed brick walls, art exhibits, and a bar that has more than 120 bottles of Kentucky bourbon. Number 8. Puebla, Mexico. While Cinco de Mayo is more of an excuse for Americans to drink margaritas than an actual Mexican celebration, Puebla is one town that actually does go all out for the holiday. The country's fourth largest city was the site of the 1862 battle that Cinco de Mayo marks, and residents honor the date with parades, fireworks, and military reenactments. But Puebla is so much more than one highlighted day on the calendar. The city is known for its delicious food. It's the birthplace of mole, gorditas, and cemita sandwiches, shops that will leave you filling a second suitcase with souvenirs, and a colorful village feel that provides endless photo opportunities. When it comes to hotels, we've been in love with Azul Talavera, formerly Rosewood Puebla, ever since it opened in 2017. Aside from its impeccable design and spacious rooms, the property has the best rooftop in the city, where you can sip a watermelon martini while gazing out over the smoking volcano Popocatépetl. Number 9. Mauna Kea, Hawaii. Astrotourism seems to become more and more popular with each passing year, with travelers planning trips and booking accommodations specifically catered to viewing the night sky. One of the world's best stargazing spots is Mauna Kea on Hawaii's Big Island, a 13,803-foot peak that's an easy drive from the city of Hilo. The dormant volcano has a world-famous observatory near its summit, from which you can see the Milky Way, bands of Jupiter, and most of the stars in both the northern and southern hemispheres. This year, we're particularly eager to visit the site in May, specifically May 26th, to witness the first total lunar eclipse since early 2019. Number 10. Zambia. Zambia is a popular safari destination, with 30% of the country allocated as national parkland. The country, which is now open to American travelers, also has the Zambezi River, which flows into Victoria Falls, one of the world's most jaw-dropping waterfalls. These natural sites are primed for a socially distanced vacation in May, which marks the end of emerald season, the time of year when the bush is green, the weather is not too hot, and the light is perfect for photographing wildlife. Book your safari trip with boutique tour operator The Bush Camp Company, which operates 6 camps in the southern parts of South Luangwa National Park. Each camp is worth staying at, but this year you should look toward the recently renovated Chindini Bush Camp, with 4 simple yet comfortable canvas tents that channel the frontier. That's all for today. For any suggestions, please leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. Thanks.